Hello, it's Polish Paul VR. I've got freshest PSVR news in the village just for you, and today I've got plenty to talk about, so we better start right now. Let's don't wait, because let's start. So first of all, I want to talk about Exorcist Legion VR. Chapter 3 release date got announced for Steam and Oculus Store, and this will come out on 25th of January. And the Chapter 3 is called Skin Deep, and to me, I think it should be called Skinny Deep. Just imagine what they could do with it. You could be skinny dipping, naked with all the demons in the sea of blood. Of course, in a slow motion, splashing bloody water on each other with some cheesy 90s porn music, while teabagging fucking offsprings of Satan. No, too far. Too fucking far, Paul. Settle down, Spaz. But anyway, Skin Deep will release on 25th of January on Oculus and Steam Store, but we want to talk about PSVR version, and they said that they are in the final rounds of VR consultation with Sony, and first two chapters will launch very soon. They keep saying it will launch very soon since October, so let's don't fucking hold our balls for it just yet. Right, okay, another story, Jumanji the VR Adventure. This is coming out from studio which brung us Ghostbusters VR Now Hiring. What a shitstorm of diarrhea that was. And Jumanji VR Adventure looks like shitstorm of gonorrhea. Gonorrhea. By Gucci, seduce her and disease her with the smell of gonorrhea by Gucci. Right, so this popped out on Steam Store for a few hours, but it was taken down. But day to day, Sony and Survoice, which are, by the way, developers of upcoming Sprint Vector, which get in closed beta. I think it's starting today for everyone apart from PSVR owners, because fuck you. So they announced that Sony and Survoice will bring it to the VR arcades. Very nice. This looks like a fucking gonorrhea. And there's too many shitty games now spreading like fucking sexually transmitted disease. But anyway, it's coming from Sony and it looks like they're gonna charge money for it. It looks fucking shit and I probably gonna buy it to review it and then tell you that it's shit. But let's talk about something good. And what is good is that the trophies for Impatient are up. And Impatient, this is the good game. This is the game to get boner over. Not just a normal boner, but one of them pulsating boners. When your dick gets so hard that it starts pulsate. Like it says, I want to grow a bit more, but I can't. So it just pulsates to the beat. So the trophies are 1 platinum, 7 gold, 10 silvers and 4 bronze. And reading through the descriptions, it looks like similar to what Until Dawn was. Like there will be a group of people to rescue. Which sounds good to me, I cannot fucking wait for this game. Apparently it's one of the bestest looking games for PSVR, so very nice. And moving on, let's talk a bit about Fumper, because how good is Fumper, it's very addictive. And of course, best experience is on PSVR. But if you cannot have enough Fumper and it so happened to be in a place where you cannot put your headset on, it's coming out on iOS. So you'll be able, or iOS, I don't know, but anyway, able to play it on your smartphone on 24th of January. And now, next story, I gonna just say it, you probably know it already, but I just want to say this line. You can now experience a snatch for free in VR. A snatch. Snatch! And it's out now in America. It's like 6 minutes long. So I didn't even download it because I don't care that much. I don't even know that much about it, apart that it's some TV drama series, whatever. And to all of you from Japan who never watches my channel, Spider-Man Homecoming VR Experience is out now in Asia. Well, doesn't make sense. And also another release, which is Flippy's Tesla, a very not good game, is released in US. It's more like for kids. I don't know if you're gonna enjoy it. I don't know who's gonna enjoy it. I don't know who is this game for. I don't know what is the purpose and what is the message, but some people might like it, so there you go, out in US. And not often I get excited by screenshots, but check out those sweet screens from V of War. It's like PUBG in VR. How cool is that? A proper esports game where VR and non-VR players will be able to play together. Awesome. And did you said that you want to see another video from Boxing Apocalypse, which I spoke about not long ago? No? Where then? Here it is. I don't know, maybe this game is gonna be good. I'm not sure, I'm not sold on it, but you know, we don't have really VR fighting games. So maybe I just prematurely prejudged this game. It's one person's effort, so let's don't be too critical about it. But anyway, it's coming to PSVR, it's out on Rift now. And to end this video, Ultra Wings had yet another patch. They keep supporting this game, one of the really good games which you should own if you got PSVR. So apparently it runs in 90 frames per second now. I didn't even know that they got down to 60s. But now on the PS4 Pro it's 90 FPS, and I don't know, as soon as I see 60 FPS, that's how my brain locks it. I can't see any more FPSs. But of course more FPS means better tracking. So there you go, very nice, and thank you for supporting this game, great efforts by the developers. And from me for today's video, that's it. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, hit like and subscribe, and I'll be back.